nine. Such a short time in life to go by. From the looks of the present, the future is predictable. Apocalyptical shadows.
And the International Criminal Court in Hague just issued arrest warrants for both the leader of Hamas and Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu. Both are charged with war crimes and crimes against humanity over Hamas's October 7th terror attack and the war in Gaza. The charges mark the first time that the court has targeted the leader of a close ally to the United States.
My office submits that there are reasonable grounds to believe that these three Hamas leaders are criminally responsible for the killing of Israeli civilians in attacks perpetrated by Hamas and other armed groups on the 7th of October, 2023, the taking of hostages, and the other crimes alleged in our applications. I can also confirm today that I have reasonable grounds to believe, on the basis of evidence collected and examined by my office, that Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu and Minister of Defense Yoav Gallant bear criminal responsibility for the following international crimes committed on the territory of the State of Palestine from at least the 8th of October 2023. The crimes include starvation of civilians as a method of warfare, willfully causing great suffering, serious injury to body or health or cruel treatment, willful killing or murder, and intentionally directing attacks against a civilian population, as well as crimes against humanity of extermination and or murder.
Welcome back. We have breaking news out of the war in Gaza. The International Criminal Court is seeking arrest warrants for Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu, the leaders of Hamas, and other officials related to war crimes. This comes as Israel's ground offensive into Rafah continues. NBC News International correspondent Raf Sanchez is in Tel Aviv. He has the latest for us. Raf, good morning. So this is a significant move, right, for the ICC. This is the highest criminal court in the world. Tell us exactly what the court is saying and explain what this does mean for both sides in this conflict.
So, Savannah, this is a day the Israeli government has been dreading for months, and now it has arrived. The chief prosecutor of the International Criminal Court officially accusing both the Prime Minister of Israel and the defense minister of war crimes and crimes against humanity. He is saying specifically that the Israeli government deliberately starved Palestinian civilians inside of Gaza by restricting the flow of food into the strip in the weeks after the October 7th attack. He is accusing Israel of intentionally attacking civilians, and he says all of this amounts to extermination and or murder. Now, he is also seeking the arrest of the three top leaders of Hamas. That is Yahya Sinwar. He is the chief of Hamas inside of Gaza. He is believed to be the main decision maker for the terrorist group in this conflict. He's also seeking the arrest of Mohammed Deif. He's the head of Hamas's military wing. And Ismail Haniyeh, who is the only one of the three who is outside of Gaza, who is the political chief. And in that case, once again, Savannah, accusing these Hamas officials of war crimes, crimes against humanity, specifically extermination, murder, hostage taking, rape, and torture. So this is about as high stakes as it can get. In terms of the legal process here, the chief prosecutor has applied for an arrest warrant to the judges of the International Criminal Court. So it is now up to a three-judge panel to decide whether to approve or decline that application. But it makes it very, very risky for them to travel to European countries that are signatories to the ICC. They could, in theory, face arrest on arrival. And it makes it very difficult for President Biden to potentially pick up the phone, meet face to face with a man who the International Criminal Court is now saying is a war criminal.